Hey guys, as you may see, I'm in my pickup today because my van is in the shop, so I'm very limited in what I can do. And I thought I would do a video I've been planning for some time about transformers and fuses, the VA ratings on them. And it's been a while since I've done a tech tips video, so here we go with one. Okay guys, let's assume you're shopping for a transformer and you may have found one that's blown. You'll notice on these transformers, they all have a VA rating. So what does the VA rating mean? That is basically volts times amps, which is the same thing as wattage. That's how many watts a transformer can handle. And I'm gonna try to show a screen here. That was a 40 VA transformer. So that means 40 watts is what it can handle. So you take that 40 and you divide it by 24. We're assuming 24 is going to be your secondary voltage, and that tells you how many watts that transformer can handle. All right, so here it is. It's 40 VA divided by 24 volts. That tells you that transformer can only handle 1.67 amps. So it's not meant for high amperage of any kind. And in fact, we often put a 3-amp fuse on these. That means between 1.67 amps and 3, there is space where that transformer can burn up, but not blow the fuse. In those instances, you need a bigger transformer, like a 50 VA or a 75 VA. I have run across this where people have tried to run a zone system off the same transformer that's in the air handler, and it don't work out. It burns up the transformer. Now, a 50 VA divided by 24 can handle 2.08 amps. And I'm going to show a picture here of a 50 VA that has a 2.5 amp breaker on it. Once again, there's a little bit of room right there where it could burn up the transformer and not trip that little breaker. So the lower the fuse, the better. I have actually seen some of them fused on the high voltage side, which is something you should never do. You can fuse on the high voltage side, but the fuse would have to be up to 10 times smaller than the one that you need on the low voltage. So always fuse on the low voltage side. Now, in more commercial equipment, you might see a transformer that reduces down to what's control voltage. It might be 120 volts. You have 120 volt contactors and stuff like that on the equipment. It's the same thing. They come in VA ratings, and the wattage rating on those is for both the high side and the low side. Either side, no matter how you hook it up, the VA rating is the same. All right guys, so I hope that was a little bit helpful in helping you decide what size transformer to get, explaining what the VA rating means, and maybe selecting the right size fuse. For example, if you're using 40 or 50 VA, you need to use the smallest one possible. Even a 2.5 is just a little bit too big for a 50 VA. So if you up the fuse size from 3 to 5, that gives it more room to burn up that transformer before it blows the fuse. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed that little video, and I hope it was informative to some of the new guys. If you like these kinds of videos, how about like and subscribe? It really does help out. I'll catch y'all on the next one.